unfortunately, for solo female founded companies, like, you know, there's just not as much funding historically that has gone to those teams. And so it's been exciting to, I think, be part of that change and, you know, to speak to other female entrepreneurs that are starting out and help provide some guidance to, you know, share our story and hopefully help them up as they're going through the same steps.
It's so true. My wife also owns her own business, and we're in the process of maybe having children. And so we're like, she's, you know, I think one thing a lot of women deal with is what happens when I'm pregnant. And so I ended up talking to a founder, this was about a year ago, and she was pregnant. And so she was raising capital. She's like, Diego, imagine being pregnant and raising capital, like, not fun, right? Yeah. And I was like, I can't even begin to imagine what that's like. But I asked her, like, what is that like for you? And is it terrifying? Because, you know, not only are you raising capital now, but you know you're going to take a leave or hopefully take some time off when the baby's delivered. And her whole thing was like, I'm just so happy I hired the right people, because that means I can leave and be totally okay. And I just thought, that's the perfect answer. Like, that's it. Like, hire the right team.
Yeah.
And so you're just doing your check-ins, you know, while taking care of your baby, but you have the right system in place. And I was just so happy that she came out with that too, because I know that answer is super personal to people and it's not talked about enough. We, you know, on our show, we've probably interviewed more female founders.
Yeah.
And as a male, it's hard for me because it's like, there are actually, like, my wife has a lot, like, I see it every day. I see what the, you know, the trouble spots are, but
yeah,
it's like, I think we just need to open up about some of these hardships a little bit more because there's so many.
And I think it can feel nerve-wracking, right? I don't have kids, but, you know, there is of course that question, right? Like, will that be held against me? Right. Is that what's not said in the room? Like, she just got married. What does that mean? You hope that wouldn't be true, but yeah, I mean, I think it's more been on, we've definitely gotten more of the, hey, beverage is pretty male dominated. We've gotten comments like, I just don't know if you or your team are tough enough, which has been sort of like eye popping, like, wow, I can't believe somebody would say that. But, you know, I think like one of the things that I have learned through the process and I always share with people is like having a strong group of advisors and mentors is invaluable. So that's thing one, you know, like you can really building out that support system is super helpful in the process. And I think the other thing is, like, sticking to your guns and knowing your worth, right?
Yeah.
Sticking to your guns anymore, but like knowing your worth, right? Like know that you're worth the same valuation as like your male counterparts are getting at that level that you're at, and holding true to that. That is really powerful. And that's one of the things that I think has been a learning curve for me.
There's a great tweet out there. So there's this, I think she's based in San Francisco too. So I forget her name. She's an author, writer, big time in the startup space. And also like does coaching specifically for female founders. And she goes, here's all I do. Female says to me, hey, what should I charge? I respond with double what you think, the end. And I just retweeted it being like, yes, like this is exactly what I tell my wife, you know, it's the same thing. And I'm like, women devalue themselves right out of the gate. And I just don't know why. And I think it's because they're so nice. Like women really look at the holistic approach. And so whenever they're giving something to a client, they're thinking about the client way more than men do. And I'm saying this honestly, like men just think about like, I'm going to make this much money. Women think about, I'm going to make some, but you know, this client has, and they just do an analysis that's very human and honest. And sometimes it doesn't work out in the capitalistic world all the way, all the time.
Yeah. And I think one of the other things that my co-founder Jordan and I talk a lot about, you know, I think bettering ourselves, or this is something I've gotten better with. And I share this if I'm ever talking to a new female entrepreneur, is you don't always have to answer the question. You know, sometimes when you're like vendors, potential investors, like, people want access to a lot of information. And I think there's a sentiment that I grew up with, which was kind of like, do your homework and have the right answer and always have it ready and, you know, raise your hand. And I think if it's information you don't want to give at that point, because it's like, you're in the negotiation, right? You don't can say like, I'm not comfortable giving that answer right now. Or like, I'm happy to share that, but I'm going to share it with you in a month or whatever that answer is. And I think holding your ground and knowing that that's valid and you don't have this responsibility to like do your homework for everybody else. Like, you can be strong and hold your ground. That's a valuable lesson as well.
That's a big tip. I know, like, what you're saying is actually a really big tip, and I hope people really latch onto it because it's so true. I'm just thinking about my wife. So my wife is a female general contractor. So she owns her own construction company, right? And so she's already in like a male-dominated world. And for her, she feels like she has to be so much better, sharper. And yeah, that naturally lends itself to you wanting or needing to have all the answers.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
When to what you're saying is really powerful, and like, you don't have to, and that's okay. And I think that's...
Or you may not want to.
Or you may not want to, right?
So like, I think that's the other thing, right? Yeah, like you have agency, you have choice there.
That's good stuff.
That's cool what your wife does.
Yeah, yeah. No, she's a badass.